Welcome to C++ Programming Tutorial Learns. If you like all these tutorials, please subscribe and like to my channel. Okay everyone, hello all guys, welcome back to my channel about C++ Tutorial Learns. In this tutorial learn, we learn about how to start and for C++ Programming Language and as the concept to write the code in C++ programming language. For all of you guys that love the C++ programming language, and you can switch and watch this video tutorial. I can take this video tutorial from the scratch until one of the wells. I can actually display or demo you to all of you guys about how to start from basic of code in C++ programming language. Hello, and I am Supert, and I am the programmer because I finished computer science, and I work with the programming language for programming language that I have skill C++. Java and C# programming. But in this tutorial, I would like to talk about C++ programming language. Okay, and now let's start with the how to start the C++ programming language. The first, you have to install IDEs. Okay, IDE for code editor in C++ programming language. And for me, I already installed the new C++ IDE on my desktop computer, and for you that you are not installed the new C++, you can go to a website and you can download. And now I start to open new C++ IDE, and then as you can see, the interface of the new C++ IDE that you can use is the version 5.11 new C++, because it's the standard IDE that you can use, and all the basic programmer use to edit C++ code over the world. And now, in order to start, you can make a file. Okay, create a new file in order to write the first program in C++. And now let in introduce, and I can start with the code and start to write the simple and easy and the short program in C++ programming. Now I try to create new file in C++ because I want to save and compile and execute a simple and easy the first programming in C++. You can click the menu bar of the new C++ IDE, and then you can see new, and you can select two options you can choose here. And first is soft file. You can create C++ soft file in order to compile and execute the C++ soft code. And the second project you can create with the new project that contain multiple soft file of C++ file. Okay, now I can select soft file. Now you can see is the first line number is the example of code editor. It's a text editor here that you can write with C++ or C or C++. And now I can try to start with C++ for the first programming. So now you can C++ is a general purpose object oriented programming language, because it was extended from C. It's similar to C, but beyond Street Staff is the computer scientist that was created C++. because C++ is 10 from C is similar to C, but just it's 10 the class that we call OOP, programming language. OOP mean that it stands for object oriented programming language, because it contain class, so we call it as C++ as OOP programming language or object oriented programming language. Okay, now I can start. The simple structure of C++ is similar to C programming language. You can make the simple file as the top level of C++ structure file. You can include standard library like C programming language also. You can include, but the different of standard libraries is if we want to run the first output simple output hello world, the line of hello world that we want to output, you can use the standard libraries that we use in C++ programming is IOStream. Okay, and IOStream is the standard libraries that we use generally all of the programmer that start to learn programming language in C++ if write IOStream input IOStream standard library. Okay, and now you can the second structure, you can using namespace. Okay, using namespace because you want to create or use the standard library, you can using namespace std. And then C and both C and C++ is always needs one main function, because main function is generally used and it is important. Only the function that can compiler can seek and can compile and execute the program. Main function is must help in C++ or C programming language. Okay, in this you can create or declare main function with integer type that need to return zero value. You must return value. Okay, and now you can create with integer main, because I want to return the value to main function, and main function you can okay, and here is the body of main function, body of main that execute. Okay, execute program. Okay, execute file, execute program. Okay, main function, if we want to return value, we can declare main function with integer type or another type. But if we don't want to return the function to main, we can declare with void. Void mean that nothing to return. Okay, mean that nothing or no types of main function. If we declare main function with integer, mean that we must return value, because we declare main function with integer type. Okay, and now you can return value with return zero in the end of statement, in the end of main. Okay, in the body here, body of main function, you can customize your code here in order to run what you want, what you imagine to see output, your output of your codes. Okay, and here the first program that I would like to output to console of C++ programming language that I want to output, I want to output single line of string, because I want to use cout. Cout is the function for output. Okay, it can print anything, it can output to the screen, because cout is the function that content in IO stream libraries. Okay, CL is a function that content in built-in library is called IO stream that we include library at the tops of top structure of C++ programming file. Okay, and can say CL, you can write something between the bulk codes. Okay. I can say hello world. Okay, because hello world is a generally line of string for the programmers that start to learn. Nearly all programming language that programmers start to write, their code is hello world is the generally used for the single line of string and the simple program outputs in C++ and either another programming language. Okay, and this I can see our hello world because I want to print a hello world to the screen, okay, to the console of C++ programming. And then I can enlarge means that I want to make a new line. And DL, this keyword mean that I want to end a new line, or I can say another output of second line of string. I can cl I like C plus plus. Okay, and this is the first simple output in C++ programming language for use to start the basic. And now, in order to compile and execute program, you can firstly you can save the file and browse the file to be stored, and in order to open the next time for you to edit your your code file. Okay, and now you can save, you can make the shortcut keys with Control S, or you can save and with the menu bar. Okay, but I would like to make the shortcut keys Control S, and you can save the file with a specific type extension, because you can see here the extension that you can save is .c. .c mean that you edit the code with C programming language, and C++ source file you can see .cpp or .cp mean that this extension is the source code of C++ programming language. Okay, I can select the C++ source code source file, and then I can put the name, or I can rename to it as the first C plus. Okay, and now you can browse via the folder that you want to save the file. I can save the file in C++ video. Okay, and now you can click save. Okay, the file has been saved because it show the file name here with the specific path that file store. Okay, and now you can compile and execute. Now I can show you how to compile and execute my C++ source code file. There are two ways that you can compile the codes and execute your C++ source code. The first, you can compile with the menu bar of C++ IDE. I can click execute, and as you can see below, compile. When you click compile, or you can use hotkey by press F9 key, to compile, and then run mean that you want after you compile your codes. Compile mean that transfer our source code to machine code, okay? And run when the machine code understand the source code file. After it compile, it run and mean that the machine execute the program of execute source code program. Okay, now you can click run or you can press F10 by shortcut key or by hot key, or you can either press F11 or compile and run together. The two tasks, compile and run, you can press F11 in the short time. You can save the short time. Okay, and now if I want to compile and run, I can click here. Wow, okay, this is the sample project. This is the display of sample project that it display. Okay, as you can see, hello world as the first line of string that I write in the source code that I would like to display, and the second it display I like C++. Okay, is the second line of string, as you can see here. Okay, all guys, and thank you for your watching my video. This is the first step of how to start to learn C++ programming language. In this video, I hopefully you will watch and you can watch another video. If you want to watch another video, and if you think this is a important first basic programming language that you need to learn, please subscribe to my channel and please like and subscribe to my channel. And thank you very much for your watching, and see you next video. Okay, thank you. Okay, hello everyone, welcome back to C++ code tutorial. In this video tutorial, I start I continue from the last tutorial that we have start for the first program of in C++ programming language. In this tutorial, we continue and learn how to use variable. Okay, how to use variable in C++ programming. Okay, use variable. So in C++ programming, we can use variable to storage temporary data. So what is variable? Variable is the data storage with the temporaries. Mean that the value of variables, the lines of value variable storage is contained only when the program is executed. But when the program finished, value of variable is terminated or it not stored. So variable is temporary storage, or we can say variable as a temporary data storage in programming. Mean that its time start have a line only when the program is start, when the program is executed. But when the program finish, the variable is finished too. So variable is very basic programming, or very important the concept of programming, how to learn variable, especially in C++. So now let's start with how to declare and use variable in C++. In order to use variable, we must declare variable. In order to declare variable, we need the keyword that specifies the types of variable that we want to declare. So in order to declare variable, we need specify keyword or identifier. In order to make the type or specify the type of variable. So the first need to create the simple and easy simple variable. The first example, I want to declare one variable that name number with the integer type. Example, I can say integer number. This is a simple, too simple and legal way to declare variable because its structure is contain keywords. Keyword mean then the special word to receive the type. Because keyword can specify the type to variable, and then you can make variable name, okay? And semicolon to end the statement. So variable can declare with keyword and then with variable name. Keyword mean that you want to specify the type of variable. In this way, I declare variable name that call number with integer type. So now I can say char that we can declare with character. Example, I can declare char letter. Or I can say string or double serial. Okay, this is the first simple how to declare three variable with different type of variable. The first variable we declare with integer type because it contain it will its value of variable can contain the real number. The second is char because I declare with char types, okay, and it contain the Unicode character. And value that we assign to character, it contain only one or single character. Double is larger integer, but it's more larger and the longer value of number than integer type. Okay, and now I can say we after we declare a variable, we can assign some value to variable. In order to assign value, we need to know the type of variable. Because if we don't want to miss type, or if we miss types or type of integer or miss type of char, we must assign the real type to variable when we declare. Example, the first that I declare with integer type, so I can assign value as a number to variable with the simple number. Example 123. And the second variable that we declare with character type, with the char keyword, I can declare and assign with character because I say the last is single keyword, a single character. I can say letter A. Okay, and now I can assign the last value of variable is that we declare with doubles. I can say serial equal. You can take more longer of value to double variable. Okay, and now you can print the value of variable to make the statement, or to make you can output the result that we assign value to variable to the console. Okay, now I can print. I can see out. Integer is integer type, integer number. Or you can say we assign the value that we assign value to variable here. You can print the value of number 123. I can say put the variable here. Variable name is number. I can put here. And the second, I can print the second line of variable that I already declare and assign. I can say letter. Letter, and then I can put variable's name here. Letter. Okay, and then I can print the last variable value, but I can say C out double value double. I can call the variable name that it contains the value that I already assigned to it, serial, that I declare with the ball type. I can say serial. Okay. Okay, now this is the example of how to use variable, that the first we must declare variable with the keywords. And then we assign value to variable and use variable to do anything like I can print the value that we assign to variable to the output console. Okay, and as you can see in this tutorial. And now when you finish and you before use compiler, don't forget save your code and then press F11 to compile and run your code. Okay, as you can see, don't forget to make the end line, make a new line of statement when you finish a line, and the line you can make the new lines with this keyword. Save again. Okay, everyone, welcome back to C++ tutorial learn. In this tutorial, I continue from last tutorial that we talked about how to get started and run the full program and how to use variable in C++ programming language. In this tutorial, we learn how to use string in C++. So what is string? String is a sequence of character. Mean that we can say string is a sequence between letters, number, special character. So the max value or the sequence that we take between double quotes, double quotes we call string. So string is a sequence of character that in programming language we can use string by, especially in C++ programming, we can, before we can use string, we can include the standard library in order to call the function with string to use in our programming. In order to call function, we can include standard libraries as a string from built-in function or standard library. I can say include string. So this is a string is a library that contain function and for we use to manipulate, delete, manipulate the string. I can take example in the main body. I can display or demo some code relevant how to use string in C++. So now let's start string. In order to use string, we can declare the type of write ball with string type. I can say string because I want to declare the string type. I can make or declare write ball with string keyword because string keyword is a write ball because string keyword is contain the type that we call from string library. Okay, and now I can say string name because I want to declare the name with string type. And the name, as you know, maybe it not contain only single character, maybe it contain multiple character. So the sequentially of character that we assign to variable name we call string and we declare with it string keyword. So you can say string name equal we assign value to string variable with it value maybe between the double quote, okay, because it value a string. We can say string and you can put your name here because this name is contain a character. So a character is a multiple character and it contain a string type. So this is a complete and legal structure how to declare and assign value to string variable in C++. Then you can make or you can do anything with string. Example, I want to print string value to console. I can print string to output console. I can say cout your name. You can put your name here. Your name. And you can put your name right ball that we assign value to name string here. You can say name. Okay, this is a sample, the first sample of how to use a string, declare and assign value to string. The second, you can match the value between character, letter, number, and special character to string value of variable string. Okay. Example, I can declare another variable string. I can say string password. Example, password. Because we put the password with the mix value between letters, between number and special character. So I can declare password with string because I want to make the sequentially character of letter, number, and special character. I can put value between the ball code because it's the string data type. So I can say password. I can put sequentially of letter, capital letter, small letter, number, and character, special character, as you can see. You can try this way, and the string is contain multiple sequentially of character. So I can print second string. I can say cout your password. Your password. I can show your password here. I can show my password here. I call what I bought password. Don't forget to create a new line. Okay, now I can take a sort the example of have to use string only declare to variable of string and print the value of string to console. As you can see, in finish, don't forget save your work, save your code after you already save, and then compile and run your code. Okay, now as you can see, this is the value. This is the result after you print the two string, two value of string. The first, we print the value your name, and the scan of string is print value password that contain multiple character that match between letter number and special character. Okay. This is a simple how to use string and work with string in C++ programming. Okay. Thank you for your watching, and this is the video tutorial about how to use string in C++ programming. Please like and subscribe to my channel for next tutorial. Hello, okay guys, welcome back everyone. Welcome back to code in C++ tutorial learn. In this tutorial, I would like to talk to all of guys about how to use function and in C++ programming. So what is function and how to use function and how many type of function that we learn in C++ programming language? Function means that we want to perform a specific task that we use function. So function, there are two types of function called built-in function and user-defined function. Built-in function is function in the library in programming language, and user-defined data type. User defined function is function that used or customized by user. I can take example. The first built-in function is example cout. Cout is a built-in function that we call from the input standard library IO stream standard library. And we can call cout. Cout is the built-in function. Okay. And user-defined function. The function that we create by ourselves, or we create by user and customize by user. Example of user-defined data type, I can say the first built-in function, I can include another standard library in order to use the built-in function from include libraries. I can say include math because I want to use math function in C++. All the math function that contain in math library, I can use with math function to our work in code. So I can call math function in order to use built-in function to you in our task in order to perform specific tasks with the built-in function. Example, I want to find the square of value of number. Square value of number, I can call square function from maths library that I already include at the top of preprocessor of structure C++ structure programming. I can call square function. So in order to assign and take the value to square function, we must declare another variable. I suppose I can declare another variable in order to assign to square function. I can say integer square number. And this square number variable, I can assign and read the value or find the value with square number variable. Example, I can say square number, because I want to find the value of square from the square function from standard math standard library. I can find square of 25, example. Now you can print the square value that we find after we use the square function from standard libraries. I can say cl square root value. Square root is 25 is, mean that we put the value of square root 25 that we assign to this variable. So we can call this variable to after the we find the square root of variable that we assign to this. We assign value to square number. So we can call this variable after we find the square value of 25. You can say square number. Okay, now you can save your work, save your code, and run compiler and run your code. Cmap. Okay. Save again. Compile. Okay. As you can see, square root of 25 is 5. Okay, maybe it's right. Great, it worked. Because the square root value of 25 is 5 in the math system. If we solve the square root, maybe 5 is correct. The square root of 25. This is a simple use of built-in library in C++ programming. And CMath is the standard library of math function that we can call relevant math function library to use in our code work. So this is an example of how we find the simple square root value of number in the tutorial. And in other ways, you can use the user-defined data type. User-defined data type is the function, or user-defined function is a function that created by user and customized by user. First of all, I can say integer sum. That this function and used to sum two or more value. Used to addition or some value to or more values. As simple, I can declare function that contain two parameter, two integer parameter, in order to sum the value between value of variable a and value of variable b. As you can see in C++ programming, when we want to use function, at the top we must declare, mean that we call prototype function. Prototype function is initialized when we create declare function at the top structure after preprocessor. Mean that the function with no body, only keywords, function name and parameter. So we can call function declare or function prototype. And in order to use the function, we can use only this. We can declare the function with the body of function, and we can take the task, perform a task in the function body. So now you can declare function here outside of main function. It's a part I can say integer sum. You can declare sum again. You can say integer a, integer b. Because this function is we declare from the prototype that we already declare at the top. This called declare prototype function, and then this called function declaration. Mean that we want to do anything with function, with the function body, we call declare function, function declaration. So you can do something here in the sum, body of sum function. You can say return, you can return value that you want to do the specific task. Example, the function, I put the name sum because I want to put the name sum. I want to sum between two values, that there are two parameters of this function. I can sum two parameters. I want to sum value of two parameters in this function. And I can return a plus b. And then return value. Return 0. This scope of function we call function declaration, because we rename, because we write again of function prototype with the body of function. So we call the specific task, we perform specific task to plus the value. So we call function declaration. In order to call function, we call in main body function. Okay, we can call function to sum between two value, because we are this function contain or there are two parameter. I can declare or I can say C out, because I want to call function in order to sum or plus between two values of integer. I can say sum of a plus b equal. And here you can call sum function here in order to sum between two values. You can say I call the sum variable here. As you can see, sum function that contain two parameter. I can say the first, as you can see, this is a metadata, because it declare about the data that already help in the code generation. So as you can see, I declare integer sum function with two parameters. So you can plus 12 and 12. This is a function call or calling function to specify the task. And now you can save your work, save your code, and compile and run your code. As you can see, after we call the function of sum, 20 that we put two arguments or parameters between integer a and integer b. Integer a we put argument value to parameter 12 and the value 12 of a parameter and b parameter. So when the function perform a task, mean that it return the value 12 plus 12, and the result of function, the result after the specific task of function is the value equal 24. As you can see, you can practice your code and solve how to solve. If there is any error, please watch any video tutorial. Okay, this is the tutorial how to use a function in C++ programming language. Thank you for your watching. If you like, please subscribe in order to see next video tutorial about how to start programming, how to start to learn C++ programming language. And see you next video tutorial. Thank you. Okay, everyone. Welcome, everyone, and all guys on this C++ code tutorial learn. On this video, I would like to talk about how to use if statement or control structure in C++ programming language. C++ programming language use if condition to make the statement according to the condition. You can use if to make decision making of statement, or we call if is a program logic. In order to use if statement, we need to make the statement with if keyword. So if statement is generally used even in C or C++ programming. And if statement used to make the condition by doing statement according to the condition. And the value of condition return true and false value. There are only two value that we call boolean value of boolean type. Boolean is contain only two values that we would like to check the condition of if statement. So now I can show you how to use if statement in C++. Okay, let's start and try your code. So we can say if, and then between the parentheses is the parameter that it is the condition that we would like to check with if. So the condition is it made the boolean type that it will result in boolean value after we check the condition. So boolean value that we check condition in if is return the true result of boolean true if the condition is making true, and it will make the statement with true condition. And L, if the condition is false, it will be returned the value if the condition is false. So two value it make the condition. Check the condition with Boolean type. So in this tutorial, and this example of code how to use if statement in C++, as you can see, you can say if example, if I want to use if to compare or decision the value that I input to when the user read the value, and you can make the prompt to input the value and make decision making. To make decision making, so I can say if I want to input value and example, I can see out to make the prompt. I can say enter number. Now you can read the value when you make the prompt for user to input value. You can read the value. As you can see, cout is the function for user to output, but cin is the function to read the value from keyboard or from user input. We use cin, so I can say cin. You can declare another variable for use in if statement. I can say integer number input, num input. And I can read the variable of number input. I can read with cin keyword. So I can say cin number input. Because I want to read the value of integer type from user that input from keyboard. So now I would like to check, and I want to make decision making to check the condition. What the condition that we provide or we assign value to the variable when the user input number from keyboard. So I can say, if I want to check, I use if to find max value. Example, I use if to find max values, maximum value. So in this statement, in this tutorial of if statement, and I will show you how to find max value of number that I input from keyboard. So I make the prompt, and I input the value that I already declare the value as integer types. So if I want to find value, I can make if statement to check the condition. Now I can say if number, if input number, if number input. So the condition, I can say if number input less than or greater than, if number input less than 10. So this make the true value of true condition. If number less than 10, mean that if the number that we input from keyboard less than 10, so it will check the true condition of each statement. So the first statement in if statement body that we want to print the true statement, if number input value of variable is greater than 10. So the first statement, when the what you drew is true. So we want to print. Example, I can say see out. This is max value. This is max value. Or I can say this is max number. Okay, this is the true statement. When the number that we input is greater than 10,That is the right statement, is the right condition. When the condition come true. So the true condition is this is max number. What if the number that we input is less than 10? What the statement that we want to output? What the statement if the condition is not true? If the condition false.So you can say another if statement, or you can use L keyword. L keyword is used to make another statement or to make the false statement if the statement is false. So it will make the L statement. I can say L.If the statement is false, so you can print the statement with the false condition. So if the statement is false, if number that we input from keyboard is less than 10, so the statement with false, we can say cout This is maximum. This is minimum, mean value, or mean value, minimum. Okay, this is a two different statement. When we check only one condition, the first statement, this is max value, is the statement that it will execute or it will call when the condition is true.Mean that if the condition that we input the value is greater than 10, so it will find this is max value statement that will call to output. But in different, if the number that we input from keyboard is less than 10, so it will fall. It will check fall to condition. So the statement will return false. That it will print this is minimum value to the screen. Okay, now when you finish, don't forget to save your code. When you finish your work, and then you can compile and run your code. Okay, now you can see the prompt for your input, for user input from keyboard, or you can input some value to check the condition. Example, I can put 23. You can print it to see the result. Okay, when I input 23, the result is this is max value. What is the statement?This is the if the statement, and it check the statement because this statement is true, because 23 that I input is greater than 10, that is return true value. So when it return true value, the statement of return is this is max value. As you can see, it print this is max valueAs you can see, and you can close the console, and you can run again to check if the condition is false. I can run again, compile and run the code again. So now you can put the value if the condition is false. The condition is we make to make decision making is value greater than 10. If I put value less than 10, so it's false. If I put age, so when we enter, okay, now as you can see, the statement that print to the result is this is minimal, because this is the statement that return from for condition. Okay, now it's work and great for this if statement. It work now, and you can test your code with if statement and many times as you can do, and hopefully you will enjoy and practice many times with this statement, because if statement is the basic concept of programming that we will continue to learn another video tutorial. Thank you for your watching, and hope see you in video for more video tutorial. Please subscribe if you like.